Okay, Ray, come here, I gotta talk to you. Bring it down a little bit for me, Willie. Tell everybody where you work, Ray.
Well, I work at Fridays at North Miami, bartending over there. I've been flaring since March, so I'm a rookie, but I'm here to party.
Got any TGI Fridays bartenders here? Ever been to a TGI Fridays? Do you know what it actually stands for? Can you spell it? First bartender is right. Get behind your bar. He's gonna have 3 minutes to make just two drinks. We'll talk about them as they go. If we're ready, we'll kick this off. I like to do it a special way. If you know me, you know what I'm talking about. I like to go 3, 2, 1, and you scream go. Can we do that? Say yeah! Yeah! All right, here we go. We ready? All right, here we go. Bring it down. Two drinks to be made. Wait for me. Wait for me. bring it. All right, there you go. Bring it down. Hit the beat when I say go. Okay, cool. All right, you're going to make for us a Carlson Iceberg and the finest call watermelon basil lemonade. Are you ready? We're doing this, everybody. On 3, 2, 1.
Go!
We are underway. We are underway. Let's do this. Oh, here you go. It is Ray from TGI Fridays. He is our rookie bartender. He's the virgin tonight. He's christening the stage. Everybody else that follows him will be getting dirty seconds. So you know what I'm talking about. Look at that Carlson's bottle, that potato vodka. Notice how user-friendly it is for the flair bartenders. It's a freaking grenade. Well, this is Ray. He's a new bartender, his first competition ever. You guys make him feel good. He can't see you, he can hear you. And Ray, there's a hot blonde down here with bunny ears who thinks you're cute. It's cute because her friend, other friend in bunny ears is like, he's talking about you, you're the blonde. Come on, right? The basic way this competition is scored, both rookie and professional, 200 points for stuff you're seeing now, moving the bottle through the air, bartender flair, experience, difficulty, smoothness, all the stuff that goes into that. The other part is mixology, the footage. I'll pick it up! A big part of this competition, because we are at Holiday Island, this is the 2013 FlareBar.com Cup. is we need crowd reaction. We want the crowd to have a good time. Entertainment points are huge. We're 200 points. Ray, you have 1 minute left. It's going to go fast, man. You got 1 minute. You heard me say 1 minute, right? Just checking. What's the trick? We don't want this night to end. We won't sleep. Won't sleep. Then we'll do it again. This is the finest called watermelon basil lemonade. It is built in the glass with actual basil. Shaken and turned up. 30 seconds, Ray. 30 seconds. That's the finest call. Start. One attempt. Three bottles. You look kind of nervous. Somebody give him a scream, please. Let him know you're happy and you're behind him. 15 seconds, Ray. I got to count you down. 15 seconds. Here we go. We got it at 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time. That's Ray. Come here. Give Ray some love. I'm serious. First comp right here. He did it for you guys.
My personal favorite Finest Call product is the agave syrup. I'm a big fan of it. It's way healthier than simple syrup. It's just as sweet. Regarding fresh versus prepared, I think it's important, once again, to remember how you use it. You know, I mean, if you're using a pre-made agave syrup, you can use that in conjunction with fresh juices to create excellent products. There's also a lot of products where there's not a significant difference between fresh and the product you can purchase. Passion fruit puree, for example, the amount of work, time, and product that goes into making it fresh, at the end, you end up with what Finest Call produces. Though pre-made purees have gotten a bad rap in the industry, I think it's much more important to focus on how you utilize them, because I think these cocktails are a great example of how you can use these purees to make absolutely amazing cocktails.
Competitor number two, say hello to Kevin Gibbon. Kevin, come here. Kevin. Hey, Mike, welcome out. All right, tell everybody where you work, Kevin.
I'm a flair instructor at Elite Bartending School. Actually, this is one of our students from the Flair Heart program.
So, Ray, you slipped into Spanish for a second. What was that?
It's actually English, proper English.
Now, say that again. Were you a flair teacher? What?
Yeah, the Elite Bartending School. We have a flair heart program. We got two of our students today, Katie over there and Ray that just competed. They've only been flaring for like 5 weeks, so it's good to. It's amazing that they can come into a competition so early, you know?
Kevin, I'll be honest with you. I wasn't really listening to you. I was watching all the girls dig your accent. That was pretty cool.
I do pretty well.
So he's a whore. Back behind your bar, we're gonna have some fun with this. Okay. I just found out from a reliable source that his apartment door apparently is revolving. So ladies, if your present action fails, here's your backup plan. Call him Plan B.
Now I can see the crossing ball.
By the way, now available over the counter. What? Oh, that was wrong. Okay, that I can't say. Yeah, we're gonna have to go.
5, 4, 3.
We have a music issue, we haven't figured out. Because of the condition, he's not able to use a CD that he brought, so he's a little handicapped. But you don't care, do you? You just want him to flip some stuff, right? Our first professional bartender is ready to go. He's got a 4-minute round. We are judges. So we get it? We good to go? Here we go. Kevin, good luck. Have some fun, brother. These people want to see you have a good time. Our first professional bartender. You're going to make for us the Carlson's Iceberg and then the finest called Watermelon Basil Lemonade. 4 minutes on the clock. Let's kick him off in style. Our first professional on 3, 2, 1. Go! His name's Kevin. We are off. He's on the clock. So I asked him to do that because this floor is freaking hot. We talked about the points, 200 points for what he's doing now. That's exhibition flair. Entertainment points, 200 points available. That's if he makes you happy. I see some smiles on your faces. You like what you see so far? Somebody say yeah! Keep doing it, Kevin. They apparently like it. Starts off with a one bottle, 110. Very UK of him. One hand column. I think there's like 25 points for a bartender can make it all the way through without dropping. That's not going to happen in this win. But every drop counts against the bartender. Just 1 point. It's worth it to go for it. And that's what Kevin's doing right now. What do you think of him so far? The single body roll on the 10. Nice. A standard 10, these are standard bottles with alcohol in them. That's a player choice bottle. The 750 that Kevin likes to throw through the air. Still working on that one bottle, 110 or 10. Nice capture. And there is liquor in that bottle. Nice pour. All that, that's how star barting is. All that work for just one shot. That's our sponsor right there, Carlson. Swedish potato vodka. It's a good drink, too. The way you make the Carlson's Iceberg is you simply ice with the Carlson's vodka in and a couple of grams of pepper, and that drink is ready to consume. We're going to have a second drink now. 2 minutes gone, 2 minutes remaining. We are halfway. What do you guys think of Kevin so far? Are you enjoying the sea? Yeah! Ladies, let me remind you, he's the one with the accent. He's the whore. Still going, he's still going. Somebody scream, please. 3 objects. That was not a drop. It wasn't pretty, but it was not a drop. Nice. 3 objects now become 2 with a 10 capture. Nice. Nice, right on beat. The judges are watching for entertainment points. How well do they use the music? Now, Kevin is not using his own music. He's stealing it as a performer. Notice how he stalled right on beat. The judges were watching. 1 minute remaining, Kevin. 3 bottles, still going. Change the pattern, back again. 3 bottles up, and notice that hands or fingers up. He's a nice juggle moves or bartending moves. At any moment, he can go straight into a pour. That's called a pass-through. These are actual glass bottles. If he misses, it's gonna be ugly. Remaining. Kevin, you're doing good. Take all the time you need, just not more than 30 seconds. Four bottles, two columns, in and out. 20 seconds. Still going. Nicely done. 15 seconds. If you like what he's doing, let's count him down together at 10, 9, Kevin Gibbon! Rolly, bring it down for 1 second. Come here, Kevin. I'm going to stand you right here. Look up. Under that, that's your spotlight right there. I'm going to get out of the way. Ladies and gentlemen, our first professional bartender. Turn up, face the crowd. What do you think of Kevin's performance, huh?
Can I have 2 more minutes just to finish my drink?
All right. No?
Yes, the process of creating something which you are satisfied with wouldn't allow you to let people blend it with something else. Just drink it as it is. If you don't like it, don't drink it. That's my attitude.
It's a very spectacular and unique landscape with very small farm lots where farming still is very active. If you want to keep that, you need to have farms that can live and thrive, and then they cannot just produce a staple product, they have to produce a high quality product.
It's a Cape who is early warm in the spring, therefore we can grow potatoes early, and it's a sandy soil. And it's not good for wheat or something else, but potatoes are good here.
Virgin new potato is traditionally the most celebrated product on the Swedish plate.
Why should such an extremely expensive raw material be used for vodka production? The only reason is that it has a flavor, it has a taste, which is different.
Our next bartender is Corey James. Doyle's on deck. Macphillip Flair standing by, then Chad Taco. Corey, you ready? Come here, buddy. Everybody say hi to Corey. Say hi, Corey.
Hi, Corey.
Nice tits, Corey. Hi. See, if I didn't say that, you'd think I was sexist, so I had to say it. All right. Come here, Corey. Where do you work, dude?
I work in Charlotte, North Carolina, at Label.
You work in Charlotte, frickin' North Carolina? How many times? Is this your first time down at Isla Mirada? First ever.
First ever.
How did you find out about bartenders going crazy during this weekend? How did you hear about this?
My tutors, Todd Bailey and DJ Ferguson.
Did he say something like, hey, dude, if you come down to Isla Mirada, you'll see girls looking like that getting body painted? Okay, I'm glad you got your fill. Get back behind your bar, make sure you're ready. Everything's like you like it. You are a rookie, which means you have 3 minutes on the clock. Judges, are we ready? About time. Are we ready with this guy? All right, Corey, here we go. Bring it out. With 3 minutes on the clock, you're going to make the Carlson's Iceberg. You're going to use that really funky-looking bottle. Then the finest called Watermelon Basil Lemonade. You know how to kick him off. He's a rookie. Make him feel good. First competition ever. Are you with him? You're going to support him? Say yeah! Here we go, Corey. On 3, 2, 1.
Go!
Bartender number 3, our second rookie of the night. Yeah, I said night. Corey James. He comes from some place where the weather sucks. But he knows how to mug the camera. That is the Carlson's Lemonade. A big shot of that Swedish potato virgin vodka. A couple grinds of pepper, and we're good to go. That's called a stall. It's a basic stall in the back of the hand. That's called a drop, a basic drop. It hit the ground. Woo! Mark calls who's watching. That's always a good thing. The finest call from the storm pour to the floor. Well, it actually rhymes. When I was supposed to be a stall, but he kind of over rotated. Just a skosh.
Hey, I can be the answer.
I like this guy. Somebody say, Corey! A minute and a half down, a minute and a half to go. We're halfway through. You need to take the top off. Yeah, there you go. Oh, rookie mistake. See, Corey, these bottles have tops on them. You have to take the top off. Come on, you guys make some noise. You're still working up here. His name is Corey. So we set. 1 minute remaining. He's masturbating. No, what are you doing? That last move, that wrist capture walk-through, that's a good move. Come here, brother. Come here. Hey, Roy, turn down for a second. In the spotlight right there, how about a big hand? First competition ever, that's Corey. Come on. From North fucking Carolina. Good job. Nice. Go get drunk.
Sidecar. It is in this heat. It's very refreshing. Finest Call always makes a great product. So this is just delicious. As far as Finest Call products go, I think my best one and favorite one has to be the Red Sangria. It's so easy. You pop it open, add a little wine, some extra fruit, and it's a perfect sangria mix. All their mixes are like spot on flavor, but I like that one the best.
I agree, but Finest Call makes it so much easier as opposed to muddling the lime. I have the mix right there ready to go, along with some of their other flavors, as for strawberry daiquiris, lime juice, grenadine, all of their stuff is great. Their products last a really long time, and they're priced awesome.
Finest Call, the premium mix for the finest cocktails.
Finest Call, premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
That's what I'm talking about.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails! Woo!
Mine is called premium mixers for premium cocktails.
And don't forget, guys, if you ever want to remember, Finest Call. It's a premium mix for premium cocktails. And we out.
Time so far. I know we just started. Are you having a good time? We got 17 bartenders we're looking at. This is bartender number 4. We're rotating rookie and professional. I want you to hang with us. Make sure you're drinking some water. Stand in the shade if you need to. But keep partying with us. We want you to be strong to the end. Our next bartender has won a few competitions. I want to introduce him to you. Please say hello to Dario Doimar. This is Dario! And ladies, if you spot when you hear an accent, hang on a second. Hey, Dario, tell everybody where you're from.
Italy.
Isn't that cute? Where do you work now?
Las Vegas.
Say it right.
Las Vegas.
Where in Las Vegas do you work?
Actually, I just started at the Catalyst Bar inside the quad.
How many world titles have you won?
Zero.
Yes, you have. Okay, that counts. Just get behind the bar. I think you're going to like this guy. 4 minutes on the clock, trust me. He's got a wingspan like a condor. I'll be surprised if he drops. You're going to go dropless?
He said drops.
No pressure. All right, here we go with Dario.
I have no idea what that means. Don't worry about it.
I'm not going to go there. 4 minutes, we're going to make the Carlson's Iceberg, and then the finest call, watermelon, basil lemonade. Finest call is the operative word there. If you're ready for this, man, you know what to do. On 3, 2, 1. Dario Garbo from Las Vegas, originally from Italy. That means, ladies, he does it on the other side of the road, I think. I don't know, I've never been. Are you watching this? Oh, yeah! Still not a spill. I think you're gonna like this guy. Dario Garbo from Italy. Making the Carlson's Iceberg, a lot of that great sweet juice. What that good Swedish. A Swedish virgin potato vodka in a glass, couple grinds of pepper, that drink is ready to consume. Finest call, star, tip number one, finest call, tip number two. Now he's gonna hit it. Now he's gonna hit it. That's what I'm looking for. It's not that sticky gross, it's actually a good, honest watermelon flavor. New out from Finest Call. If your bar doesn't carry, it should. Off the top, Finest Call, it's in there. The time goes by, so one bottle, 110. This is how they do it in Italy. Too quiet out there. Somebody scream, please, Dario! I saw the helicopter. No look behind the head. Sweet! I think this is Dario's second time down to Ivan Morata for our player competition. The FlyerBars.com Carlson's Finest Call Competition 2013. Somebody scream, please! Halfway, plenty of time. Oh, yeah! You realize he's working with four objects, and he keeps swapping them out. Nice. One, two. Come on, somebody make some noise. It's too quiet out there. What do you think? Are you having a good time with this guy or what? Three, Carlson. Swedish virgin. They don't fuck the fuck. You didn't say it that fast. The way the bartenders use the sponsor's product is paramount. We're being judged on this too. Featuring the Carlson Vodka. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 in the backhand. Stop! To the freaking potato bottle! Dario, 30 seconds, 30 seconds. Come on, we want some more! I want 18 bottles. Let's go! That's a quick tomahawk back through, changing the routine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Somebody scream, please. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go, go, go! How many points is that?
10-point bonus.
I just got to... Exactly. Hey, judges, do we have a drop? Zero drops? That's 10 bonus points right there. Dario, come here. Come here. Dude, you're so getting late tonight. I'm getting out of the spotlight, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. How about that for our professional bartender?
Most vodkas are distilled many, many times. They try to produce something which has no smell or taste at all. The whole idea of this project was to create something which had a taste of potatoes. That was the idea.
Cosm vodka is made from 7 different variety of potatoes. We only distill once and what they call an unfiltered approach. And the reason for that is that we made such a big effort on growing and picking the potatoes that really makes a difference. Someone has taken great care from the very beginning. This is not an anonymous sort of raw material that has just been packaged into some kind of fancy label. And this is something unique from a unique region with a unique care and a lot of people and basically a whole community that stands behind it.
Now remember the pack we have. We go rookie, professional. You guys have been awesome so far, giving love to these guys who are new out of the gate. Our next bartender is bartender number 5, Max Flair. Is that really your last name, Flair?
No, my initials are MAC, so they just put Flair on the back of it.
Okay. What's your first name?
Matthew.
Dude, that's so gay. Go with Matt. Good call. Where do you work, dude?
You go, girl.
Dude, that's down. That's about 80 miles that way.
All right, bro. No problem.
Mac, where do you work?
I work at Shirky's Place in Gastonia, North Carolina.
Wait, another guy from North Carolina? How many people from North Carolina are here? This shit. Well, fuck that. Just ask. How many people from out of the state here? Period.
Oh, shit. Look at that.
Wow. Welcome to Holiday Isle. Okay, sorry, Mac. Where do you work?
Shirky's Place in Rick's Pizza.
Rick's Pizza?
Yeah.
You flip pizzas?
I flip pizzas and bottles, actually.
Sweet! It should be a lot of fun. I'm looking for a lot of helicopter stuff out of you, okay? He flips. Get back behind your bar. And remember, you have 3 minutes in your routine. How many competitions have you been in so far?
About 2, 3.
This is your second or third?
This is my 4th.
Okay. Well, let's have some fun doing it. I like your shirt. You got the DC, sporting the DC comic label. Dig. I see who your heavy is. Here we go. Will, are we ready? We good to go?
Yes, sir.
Judges, are we ready? More importantly, Ira Morata, are you ready for our next competitor? Say yeah! Let's do this with 3 minutes on the clock. Mac, I need you to make for me, please, your 2 drinks. The Carlson Iceberg, the finest call, watermelon basil lemonade. When you're done, you're going to give them out to people that appreciate you, so let's have some fun, all right? Let's do this, everybody. You know what we need. You know the word I need. It begins with G. 3, 2, 1. No! She actually went. This is our third rookie bartender, Matt Flair from North frickin' Carolina. Where are my Latinos at? Latino! Boricua, Boricua, Colombiano, Cubano, anything that ends with ano. Fuck it.
And for those speaking English, I am not talking about your mother. Don't worry about it.
That is a Swedish virgin potato. Vodka. Cut you that one breath. That's Carlson's right there. The iceberg made with a lot of that good vodka. A couple grinds of pepper. And we're solid. Finest call. This is the finest call competition. The finest call stars feature. Each bartender must attempt 2 finest calls. The best stall at the end of the day will get some money out of it. Somebody from North Carolina, scream, please. Oy, 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 oy cocktail. It's pretty. One bottle, 110, he's still working it. That's called the shadow pass. Behind the head, two bumps and it's in. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 9, 10. 2, 1 minute remaining. Max, 1 minute. Nice. The potato bottle. No, my name is Carlson. Nice, nice. Price is back. Somebody scream, please. He's a rookie. Hey, Mac, you're having a good round, bro. Finest car, it's in there. The brand new Finest car, watermelon. 15 seconds. I need some basil. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's back. You know it's basil lemonade, right? I'm gonna get out of your spotlight, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth competition ever, all the way from North Carolina. How about a big hand for Mac? You just put on a show for your rookie bartender. Solid show.
My personal favorite Finest Golf product is the agave syrup. I'm a big fan of it. It's way healthier than simple syrup. It's just as sweet. Regarding fresh versus prepared, I think it's important, once again, to remember how you use it. You know, I mean, if you're using a pre-made agave syrup, you can use that in conjunction with fresh juices to create excellent products. There's also a lot of products where there's not a significant difference between fresh and the product you can purchase. Passion fruit puree, for example, the amount of work, time, and product that goes into making it fresh, at the end, you end up with what Finest Call produces. Though pre-made purees have gotten a bad rap in the industry, I think it's much more important to focus on how you utilize them, because I think these cocktails are a great example of how you can use these purees to make absolutely amazing cocktails.
And the crowd is getting thicker, you guys. Thanks for hanging with us. We have 17 bartenders working at tonight. $500 to the best pro bartender. We have our next one up right now. We're rotating rookie and pro. Our next performer is Chad Taco. You're going to meet him right now. He is a professional bartender, which means he has 4 minutes to entertain you. But first, let's find out something about our bachelor. Otaka, what's going on?
I like walking down the beach and stuff like that. Is that what you want to know? What was it called?
I don't know, but I think you're getting a stiffy. Tell everybody where you work, dude.
I work at room service. That's the Saturday promoters. They're this shit. I also am representing Elite Bartending School. I'm an instructor. And, I'm going to flare for you now.
So, an elite bartender, and apparently, ladies, he's good with room service. I don't know what that means, but if you... Okay, he works in South Beach, so maybe he works both sides of the road. I don't know. It could be a turn-down service. If you want more information, talk to him. I don't know. Taco is ready. He has 4 minutes on the clock. Music man, Romo is ready. Judges, are you ready? Adam Morana, are you ready? Yeah! All right, Taco, here we go. 4 minutes. We need Basil. We got Basil. Make for us the Carlson Iceberg. Taco, I need you in this general area when I... Okay, just saying. Again, we need the Carlson Iceberg. The fight is called Watermelon Basil Lemonade. You guys have been good so far. His name is Taco. You know what to scream when I say... 3, 2, 1! Go! Our third professional bartender, Chad... Call it Taco. 4 minutes on the clock. 2 drinks to be made. Let's have some fun. Welcome to the finest call. Carlson, flambar.com. Bartender competition here once again at Holiday Island 2013. It's a new state. It's a new day. We got a new vodka. Fun some fun. Well, that is going to be a good drink. The Carlson Lemonade made with that Swedish virgin potato vodka. Mixologists, get to know this brand before the weekend is done. Carlson Vodka, that looks like a potato. That's a body roll. I love the thing this man does. It's walking 1 bottle, 110. His name is Taco. Somebody say Taco! 3, 4, 5, 6. That's called a helicopter. It landed. Black ops. Woo! Shroom! Nice fishnets. Come on, Taco, let's go! Oh. 2 bottles now. A shadow pass into his stall. Other hand around. Pulls out a full long. Just a little off. It's too quiet. Somebody's ready to bartender to scream, please!
I've been to the beat, walking down the street, and my new freak, yeah.
All right, Taco, 2 minutes gone, 2 minutes remaining, 3 bottles now, halfway.
The big ass bro, and like Bruce Lee, where I got the clap, yeah.
3 bottles. Back into the tomahawk. We're back around. Notice the grip.
just the process of creating something which you are satisfied with wouldn't allow you to let people blend it with something else. Just drink it as it is. If you don't like it, don't drink it. That's my attitude. It's a very spectacular and unique landscape with very small farm lots where farming still is very active. If you want to keep that, you need to have farms that can live and thrive, and then they cannot just produce a staple product, they have to produce a high quality product.
It's a Cape who is early warm in the spring, therefore we can grow potatoes early, and it's a sandy soil, and it's not good for wheat or something else, but the potatoes are good here.
Virgin new potato is traditionally the most celebrated product on the Swedish plate. Why should such an extremely expensive raw material be used for vodka production? The only reason is that it has a flavor, it has a taste, which is different.
Alright. Because judges, are you ready? Ira Murata, are you ready for our next bartender here at the Flair Carlson Vodka? Please make for me in your 3 minutes allotted, Todd. We got the Carlson's Iceberg. And then the finest call, Watermelon Basil Lemonade. Let's do this, everybody. He's a rookie, so make him feel good. On 3, 2, 1. FlareCoCarlsonFlareBarn.com Poor Stars FBA Flare Competition. And I'm the Murata. Howdy out. We're back again. Our next bartender is working for you. 3 minutes on the clock. 2 weeks to be made. Welcome to Traffic Code and the Carlson's Vodka. That's too close. Somebody make some noise, please. Come on, he's working up here. Thank you. Todd?
Keep burning like that fire. I'm alive.
200 points for barn skills. Joe! I want to see that. 200 points for entertainment value. That's what he's working on right now. I want to see that move. I want to see it. Using the mohawk. Hey! His name is Todd. Somebody scream, please. Todd! Thank you. Finest call, attempt number one. Superman! 1 minute remaining, Todd. 1 minute. Oh, label out, good. Firebar.com, that's important. That's a brand new finest call, Watermelon. Sponsor favorite. From back here, it looks like you're peeing, dude. You pee like a girl. 30 seconds. Uh-oh. 15 seconds. With the number. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, Bailey, North Carolina. By the way, did you like what he did up here? Wasn't that cool? Girls in North Carolina, when they pee in the snow, that's what they do. Guys, let's do that.
Finest call, cinnamon apple sidecar. It is in this heat, it's very refreshing. Finest call always makes a great product, so this is just delicious. As far as Finest call products go, I think my best one and favorite one has to be the red sangria. It's so easy, you pop it open, add a little lime, some extra fruit, and it's a perfect sangria mix. All their mixes are like spot on flavor. But I like that one the best.
I agree, but Finest Call makes it so much easier as opposed to muddling the lime. I have the mix right there ready to go, along with some of their other flavors. As for strawberry daiquiris, lime juice, grenadine, all of their stuff is great. Their products last a really long time, and they're priced awesome.
Finest Call, the premium mix for the best cocktails.
Finest Call, premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
That's what I'm talking about.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails! Woo!
Mine is called premium mixers for premium cocktails.
And don't forget, guys, if you ever want to remember, Finest Call. It's a premium mix for premium cocktails, and we out.
Dude, hopefully you went down there and put on more sunscreen. Please tell me you put on more sunscreen.
Just a little bit. I'm an Irishman. Putting me in the sun is like putting a
microwave. Ladies and gentlemen, our fourth professional bartender, please welcome Danny to the bar. Say hi, Danny.
Hi, Danny.
You can say hi, Danny boy.
Hi.
Hold on. This is Bartender's Bash. I know you guys have been drinking all day, and I really want to hear you guys say hi. So on three. One, two, three. That's more like Bartender's Bash.
Keep going. Tell everybody where you work.
Like you said, my name is Danny. I bartend at Lou's Beer Garden in Miami Beach. I'm going to be doing a completely local and fresh cocktail program.
Did you say
next
boner?
Week.
You said boner. I heard boner.
I did say boner.
Okay, just check.
Just I so heard you boner.
No, keep talking. No,
still
seriously.
Down there?
No, keep going. Please, please, please. How about a big hand for Danny? Get him back behind the bar. Come on. That was so comfortable.
I heard boner. What the fuck? How? What?
It scares me that word.
I got people
out.
Looking at me right now. Oh my god, he said boner. I didn't say dick. You know what I mean? What do you want?
Danny Siegel's a professional bartender. 4 minutes on the clock. Are you ready, Rolo? Are you ready?
Gatorade is thirsty.
I don't know. Rolo?
Pop him, Molly. I'm sweating.
On three, two, one, go! You're talented. Here we go. Seriously, this man's in the running for the big money today. Watch what he does. Let him see. Swedish, bourbon, potato, vodka, Thompson. Guys, call stop. That's one. That's the second. Somebody scream, please. I say. I did it. 2 minutes gone. 2 minutes remaining. Let's have some fun. We're still working. Sometimes it's hard to get it in the hole. Sometimes it takes a few times. I think the perfect 10 would have 2 holes. 3 bottles, 1 bartender. Somebody scream, please. His name is Danny. Danny boy. How about 4 bottles? Here we go. 1 minute remaining. 1 minute. 2 columns. Three traffic cones in a bottle. 4 objects. This is working now. Hi, Danny. 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Nice. Somebody scream! Oh, dude, you're right there. 15 seconds. I gotta count you now. Somebody help me, please. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time. Danny Siegel. Really? Really? After all that, that's all you got? You guys are getting jaded. Think about it. No, no. Think about it. Now, one more time for Danny. Come on. Good job, Danny.
Most vodkas are distilled many, many times. They try to produce something which has no smell or taste at all. The whole idea of this project was to create something which had a taste. A taste of potatoes. That was the idea.
Carlson vodka is made from 7 different variety of potatoes. We only distill once and what they call an unfiltered approach. And the reason for that is that we made such a big effort on growing and picking the potatoes that really makes a difference. Someone has taken great care from the very beginning. This is not an anonymous sort of raw material that has just been packaged into some kind of fancy label. And this is something unique from a unique region with a unique care and a lot of people and basically a whole community that stands behind it.
We started this competition with 17 bartenders. It is a professional and rookie bartender competition. We've been alternating rookies and professionals. Our next rookie is ready to go. The top rookie will be walking away with a trophy tonight and $100. A professional bartender, if you poop, can I say poop? If you shit the bed and come in third and you're really good, you still walk with $200. Second place gets $300. The best professional bartender in this competition tonight, theflarebar.com. Carlson's Flair Co. Who am I missing? Bar Stars. Finest Call Competition. $500 for the best bartender. Our next bartender is ready to go. She happens to be a female, ladies. Katrina. And your dad is here, isn't he? Hey, Dad, come here. I want to give you a good seat. Come here. Come here, Dad. Come here. What do you think? Yeah. Come here, Dad. Hey, Dad, backstage. Right over here, up the steps.
That's awesome.
Oh, what the fuck?
Come on, Dad. Everybody, this is Katrina's dad right here. Make some noise for Dad. Have a seat, sir. Welcome to the competition. I'm not putting any pressure on you, am I? Come here, Katrina. Come on out here. Where are my lady bartenders at tonight? Give your dad a kiss. Give your dad a kiss. Give your dad a kiss. Thank you, Daddy. Tell everybody where you bring it down, DB. Bring it down this way. Tell everybody where you work.
I have no job right now.
She is un- Aren't we proud of her?
I'm looking at this little job application right here.
Yeah. So you're looking for work?
Yeah.
Where do you live?
Miami.
How long have you been bartending? Miami! How long have you been bartending?
2 years now.
How long have you been flaring bar?
Like 3 or 4 months. 4, 5.
Hey, Dad, does she make it? Does she make a good drink? All right. Does she have fun while she does it? All right. Katrina, get back behind the bar. Professional bartender, amateur bartender, number 5, Katrina, with Dad sitting on stage. She has 3 minutes on the clock. She's going to make the same 2 drinks that everybody else has made. The Carlson's Iceberg, finest called watermelon. I've lost my stopwatch, apparently. Uh-oh. Hold on. I got it. I know. Finest called watermelon basil lemonade. All right, so bring the music down. Let's do this. So once again, you're going to make the Carlson's Iceberg, the finest called watermelon basil lemonade. Let's kick her off in style. I'll say 3, 2, 1, you scream go. Here we go, everybody. 3, 2, 1.
Go!
Rookie bartender number 5, bartender number 9 of the day, Katrina. Lady bartenders, I give you your champion. She even has a pink one. Oh, a pink 10. That's so cute. And scream and shout and let it out. Say no, we love, we love. It's way too great. How many of y'all? Somebody scream, please! That is the sweetest virgin potato vodka. With the potato bottle, I'll go to the stall. Nice, you don't work around. Still looking good. I love the smell. Of all the bartenders today, Katrina, I can honestly say you have the best ponytail. Nicely done, the finest call still, huh? That was good, that was good. That is the brand new finest call still, lands with the brand new finest call. Watermelon, it's in there. Yeah! A little bit of basil. Farm roll. One bottle, 110, one ponytail. That's almost 3 objects. I need a lady to scream, please. Man, I love that sound. One bottle, 110, she's got it going on. Nice. Nice. Ah, brings it around, lays it with your fingers, touch and go. Touch and go. Oh, oh. 1 minute remaining, 1 minute, she used the boob on that one, that was pretty cool. Flarebar.com 2013 Finest Call Competition on the main stage today. 30 seconds remaining. Katrina, get it. Full up stall. Back around. Sweet. There you go. 15 seconds. We got to count you down. I need everybody's help for this lady. We got it on 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, two, one, she's still smiling! Katrina! 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 I'm gonna get out of your spotlight. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please for our lady bartender tonight. Rookie! Number 5, Katrina, doing a great job! She did you proud. She did you proud.
My personal favorite Finest Golf product is the agave syrup. I'm a big fan of it. It's way healthier than simple syrup. It's just as sweet. Regarding fresh versus prepared, I think it's important, once again, to remember how you use it. You know, I mean, if you're using a pre-made agave syrup, you can use that in conjunction with fresh juices to create excellent products. There's also a lot of products where there's not a significant difference between fresh and the product you can purchase. Passion fruit puree, for example, the amount of work, time, and product that goes into making it fresh, at the end, you end up with what Finest Golf produces. Though pre-made purees have gotten a bad rap in the industry, I think it's much more important to focus on how you utilize them, because I think these cocktails are a great example of how you can use these purees to make absolutely amazing cocktails.
Flip, come here. Come here. Everybody say hi, Flip. Hi, Flip. Tell everybody where you're from, bro.
I'm originally from Duluth, Minnesota, all the way up north.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I like Minnesota people. You're my favorite now.
Other than my girlfriend. She's right there.
By the way, Flip, you're back defending your championship. You won this thing last year. No pressure, but
I know. Well, you know, I hoped Dario was just competing in mixology, but that didn't happen. So here we are. You know, let's do this shit.
Get back behind your bar. His name is Slip. He's gonna perform for you right now. Judges are ready. Crowd, you're ready. Last year's winner going right now. 4 minutes on the clock. This year we're using the brand new Swedish Virgin Potato Vodka. Make for us the Carlson's Iceberg. Your second drink. The Finest Call Watermelon Basil Lemonade. Let's do this. Everybody, are you ready? Say yeah!
Yeah!
Give me the G word on 3, 2, 1.
Go!
Flipper! Dad and Dawson.
I'm gonna get you drunk. Get you drunk off my lady, my lovely lady,
of course, my red-hot smoking wife, Carly.
200 points and flipping skills. That's what he's doing right now, working the sponsor bottle, the Carlson Swedish Potato Vodka, 110. Sponsor points going right there. Very important for each competitor. Nice plum
stuff. And I need all of you to stop what you're doing and listen.
Nice. Last year's winner right here.
not Jackie Moon, will wrestle a bear.
Good use of choreography with the music. Any other type of choreography really isn't. Shut up.
You are a smelly pirate hooker.
Three objects now, one bright and two sharp. Those are two tens. It's like 20.
I'm the greatest man in the world.
Are you guys watching this? Let him know you're watching this. Somebody make some noise, please. That was very subtle. Oh! The wet air taking its toll on that last move. Try to do a double spindle, that would have been cool. But unfortunately, it's not. What about a minute and a half? Finest cross stall attempt number one. Each bartender must attempt it twice or they will be penalized. Or penalized. You like Tom. Three bottles! A couple pass-throughs. 1 minute! 1 minute! Take all the time you need. Just stop more than a minute. Nice. One finger!
Come on, girl.
Is called star number two. He landed it, and now it's something completely different. 30 seconds. By the way, that was a brand new finest called watermelon. 15 seconds. Getting urgent. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you're pissing me off, scaring me like that. Last time! Sit right there, turn off, face away. I'm gonna get out of your spotlight. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, how about a big hand for the bunny lover right there? That's Flip! Yes, he needed another minute. Last year's winner. Did you like that? You think he's in contingency? Yeah, that was a good show, guys. Okay.
Yes, the process of creating something which you are satisfied with wouldn't allow you to let people blend it to something else. Just drink it as it is. If you don't like it, don't drink it. That's my attitude. A very spectacular and unique landscape with very small farm lots where farming still is very active. If you want to keep that, you need to have farms that can live and thrive, and then they cannot just produce a staple product, they have to produce a high quality product.
It's a Cape who is early warm in the spring, therefore we can grow potatoes early, and it's a sandy soil. And it's not good for wheat or something else, but potatoes are good here.
Virgin new potato is traditionally the most celebrated product on the Swedish plate. Why should such extremely expensive raw material be used for vodka production? The only reason is that it has a flavor, it has a taste, which is different.
This is our next performer. He is number 11 on your sheets, judges. Rookie bartender number 6, DJ. Bottle flipping. Say hello to DJ, everybody! DJ! Welcome back, brother. Hey, I've been all right. Busy year. DJ Ferguson. DJ. Tell everybody where you work, DJ.
Well, born and raised in the 305, but now I reside in South Carolina, the 704. North Carolina. I'm sorry.
You really from North Carolina?
No, born and raised here, baby.
Oh, that's what I wanted to hear. All right, turn around. Respect, Airborne. Yeah, respect.
All the way.
Get back behind the bar, sir. We got some to eat. We got some drinks tonight. Here we go, our sixth rookie bartender. 3 minutes on the clock. Here we go. Please make for you three ice. Now here we go. Carlson, I need you to make for me, please. What are you doing? What are you doing? Come here. Hold on. Stop. I got a starting. He hasn't started yet. Yeah, see, you can ice the drinks ahead of time. That's okay. You can, settle down. I want you to use all your time to your advantage.
I'm drunk.
He goes. I'm drunk. I respect you more. Okay, 3 minutes on the clock. I'm going to kick you off right to give you your full time, right? I need you to make the Carlson Iceberg and then the finest call, watermelon, basil lemonade. Here we go. Doing this together on 3, 2, 1, go! Here we go. Jeff Jones, check in. Rookie bartender number 6, DJ. Ferguson. Bounce pass. Look at that Carlson, man. Represent. That's the way to do it right there. Somebody speed, please! Oh! I think the first time tonight we've actually had pepper flare. Whoa. That's a spicy meatball. It's only been out a year, the brand new Swedish virgin potato vodka Carlson is in the potato bottle. Get that up. Come on, DJ. Nice, I like that. I like this guy's style. I need a bartender to scream right now. Bartender, scream! Finest call. Look at the brand new watermelon right there. That's the red one. Nice. Oh! Where's his ass, everybody? One minute remaining. Nice. He does a lot of squats, apparently. 15 seconds, DJ. We need you. 15 seconds. I gotta count you down. Here we go. At 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Somebody make some noise. Come on, he just worked for you. 3 minutes of work. Hard. Labor intensive.
He's done.
He went up to the today. He was like, filming. He goes, this is the first time I've ever been doing this competition drunk as fuck. The last two times he did it, he did it sober. This time he's like, I'm drunk.
I'm going to get out of this man's spotlight right now. You're drunk. How about a big hand for DJ? Come on, a rookie bartender. Good to see you, man.
Sidecar. It is in this heat. It's very refreshing. Finest Call always makes a great product. So this is just delicious. As far as Finest Call products go, I think my best one and favorite one has to be the Red Sangria. It's so easy. You pop it open, add a little wine, some extra fruit, and it's a perfect sangria mix. All their mixes are like spot on flavor, but I like that one the best.
I agree, but Finest Call makes it so much easier as opposed to muddling the lime. I have the mix right there ready to go, along with some of their other flavors. As for strawberry daiquiris, lime juice grenadine, all of their stuff is great. Their products last a really long time, and they're priced awesome.
Finest Call, the premium mix for the best cocktails.
Finest Call, premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
That's what I'm talking about.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails! Woo!
Mine is called premium mixers for premium cocktails.
And don't forget, guys, if you ever want to remember, Finest Call. It's a premium mix for premium cocktails, and we out.
Bartender, his name is Colby. Everybody say hi, Colby!
Hi!
Say hi, Colby!
Hi, Colby!
They love you anyway. Tell everybody where you're from, man.
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
I'm guessing they are too, or they just like to scream in unison. What? Get back behind your bar. This is the important part. His name is Colby. He's going to perform for you right now. Judges, he's bartender number 12, professional bartender number 6. We're rotating amateur and professional. $500 to the best professional bartender we choose tonight. You can choose by going online and voting for your favorite bartender. Grab one of these little cards that say vote. Take a picture of it. It'll prompt you how to do the rest. Colby, are you ready, sir? Okay, pre-ice. That is allowed. Here we go. I'm going to read the drinks and say go. Here we go. We got 4 minutes on the clock. You're going to make for us, please, a Carlson Iceberg, then the Finest Call Watermelon Basil Lemonade. We're going to kick him off. Isla Morada, you know what you do. Say go on 3, 2, 1, go! All right. Hold on. Back up. We're going to reset. Let's try this again. Hold on. We'll reset. That's all right. All right. We got this. We'll reset. No worries. Chick. Better chick. Yeah, one track, single track. No worries, we reset. All right, we'll do this again. Reset, judges, are you ready? Give him a right read and send him off again. We had the wrong track queued up. That's what happens in a live show. Once again, the Carlson Iceberg, the Finest Call Watermelon Basil Lemonade. On 3, 2, 1,
go!
Welcome to prom, graduation, 2013, seniors. Go forth! That was Finest Call Stall right there, beautifully done. Great gig, I hope you saw that. The song is called Carlson Basil Lemonade, already half made. Working like a beach boy, all his tins are white. Three objects, one bottle, one is the Carlson. Four objects, splits it out. This guy's very subtle. If you are a flair bartender, you might want to pay attention. You might miss something. Label out. He's pointing out the subtleties. Please tell me you're watching. The wind's kicking up. He's working with two tins in this wind. Three tins, I'm sorry. That's like 30 in one bottle. Effortless. Good, you're paying attention. I like that in the crowd. You guys have seen 11 bartenders so far. And don't worry, we'll Photoshop that in later. When we feature this video on flairbar.com, we'll make it look perfect. Pepper grinder flare. I'm going to put that in the other drink, but that's just me. 2 minutes remaining. Somebody yells, "Sheesh!" Wow, I couldn't help but smile. Nice, nice. Let's go, choreography. The judges saw it. We nodded. Minute and a half remaining. I lost count, but basically we're working with a shitload of tens. Three in that hand, three in that hand. That's seven objects. Are you watching this? Into a four. Somebody scream, please. Hey, Miami. Hey, Miami. Three bottles now. You know your music, but I'm going to tell you, 45 seconds. Three bottles, still working. The wind is kicking up again. Please tell me about... Are you watching this? Do you stop holding the end of... Oh! Oh! Nice save! 15 seconds. Damn good routine, Goldie. Finish it up. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time! Honestly, were you watching that? What did you think of that routine? Kobe, come here. Yeah, Pepper goes in that one. That's all right, one minor mistake, not a big deal. Stand right there, I'm going to get out of your spotlight. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, no kidding. How about a big hand for that performance? That is worthy. Good job, Coley.
Most vodkas are distilled many, many times. They try to produce something which has no smell or taste at all. The whole idea of this project was to create something which had a taste of potatoes. That was the idea.
Carlson vodka is made from seven different variety of potatoes. We only distill once and what they call an unfiltered approach. And the reason for that is that we made such a big effort on growing and picking the potatoes that really makes a difference. Someone has taken great care from the very beginning. This is not an anonymous sort of raw material that has just been packaged into some kind of fancy label. This is something unique from a unique region with a unique care and a lot of people and basically a whole community that stands behind it.
Ladies and gentlemen, next bartender is right here. What the hell are you doing, Jenna? Swallow. Nah, too easy. Everybody say hello to our next competitor. His name is Jeff Jones. Say hi, Jeff!
Hi, Jeff!
Jeff is a rookie bartender. You realize if you take your category, you'll get a $100. That's pretty cool. Not bad. Doesn't suck. Tell everybody where you work, sir.
I own the Poor Doctors Mobile Bartending Service, and I work in Miami Beach at Bal Harbor Shops, Makoto.
Yeah. Seriously, how do we find you online?
Check me out at poordoctors.com or facebook.com/thepoordoctors. Make it happen.
Do you work Orlando?
Man, I've been to Orlando, South Beach. We've done Jacksonville. We're all over the state. Poor Doctors like to party, man.
Sure, my fiance has your card, okay? Put him back behind the bar. He's going to make some drinks for us. If you just joined us, this is a flair competition. 3 minutes for the rookie bartenders, only making two drinks. And if we're ready, we'll do it now. We good? Hang tight. I'm going to count. Making for us the Carlson Iceberg, the finest call, watermelon, basil, lemonade. This guy's going to have some flair behind him. Let's kick him off with 3, 2, 1, go! Jones, he works out of Miami. He has a portable bar business. He'll come and make drinks in your house. Bad form. If you're unfamiliar with that bottle, then you're unfamiliar with the newest vodka on the scene. It is a Swedish virgin potato vodka. Carlson's Gold. Distilled once, filtered zero times, all the flavors in there. For the iceberg, you pour it on ice, a couple grounds of pepper, and you're gold. Notice, Kobe, you put it in the white glass. Find his call, spell it easy, tipped it twice, he did. There you are! One bottle, 110. Working the traffic code. Word, ain't heard my album, we sleeping on. You should print the lyrics out and have a fucking read along. Ain't a fucking sing along unless you roll the weed alone. And just, nice. One bottle, 210. We can stay up at the stars and put the Beatles on. All the shit you talking about is not up for discussion. I will pay to make it bigger. I'm keeping no reduction if it's coming from a nigga. I don't know that I don't trust it if you're coming from my head. And motherfucking people must be like, just don't. I don't really say that. Nice, fine, it's called Stop. On the top, nice and dust. The pillar is still to the glass, just like that. 1 minute remaining. Jeff, 1 minute remaining. Take all the time you need. I see you guys smiling and dancing out there, but somebody scream, please! Come on, we got a working bartender out here. 30 seconds, I'm in the way. 3 bottles. Like a nigga don't exist. Yeah, I know you want that dick. I'm Kendrick Lamar. Time.
My personal favorite Finest Golf product is the agave syrup. I'm a big fan of it. It's way healthier than simple syrup. It's just as sweet. Regarding fresh versus prepared, I think it's important, once again, to remember how you use it. You know, I mean, if you're using a pre-made agave syrup, you can use that in conjunction with fresh juices to create excellent products. There's also a lot of products where there's not a significant difference between fresh and the product you can purchase. Passion fruit puree, for example, the amount of work, time, and product that goes into making it fresh, at the end, you end up with what Finest Golf produces. Though pre-made purees have gotten a bad rap in the industry, I think it's much more important to focus on how you utilize them, because I think these cocktails are a great example of how you can use these purees to make absolutely amazing cocktails.
Professional bartender number 7, judges number 4 on your scorecard, Josh Kohler. Everybody say hi, Josh! Hi. Josh! Come here. Tell everybody where you're working now.
What's up, guys? We're for Elite Bartending School and Rick's Dirty Harry's in Key West, Florida.
See, I was gonna guess Ross. 99 cents, dude, you paid too much.
Just doing some discount shopping, man.
You see, you can always tell somebody that lives and works in Key West. See what I'm talking? They're just fun to hang with. Sorry, brother. We're gonna go with what we got. Let's do this. Here we go. Two drinks to be made. We have a professional bartender, which means 4 minutes on the clock. We're making the Carlson Lemonade, and the Finest Call Watermelon Basil Lemonade. Let's do this on 3, 2, 1, go! Josh Boners! Dude, you just ruined the freaking shirt! Josh has been coming up to Holiday Island to participate in this competition for several years now. It's always fun to see what he brings out. Now with a new bottle and a new sponsor, the Swedish Virgin Potato Vodka. Nice words. That's the Carlson Gold. Finest Call. Stop! It's the parrot irony. You both have the parrot style. Pepper grinder. Quick shadow pass with a pepper grinder. First time ever in competition. I could be wrong about that. He's getting naked. Hey, Scotty Clark, can I get a bartender to scream, please? If you've ever gotten drunk in Key West, give me a scream. Hell yeah. Oh. Shuffle pass. Nice. Nice one bottle, 110. He's working it, y'all. 2 minutes for half. Halfway. 2 minutes gone. 2 minutes remaining. Halfway. Nice. Is he done? I told you we'd hear some more, we see some old school stuff. I like it. 1 minute remaining. Josh, take all the time you need. Just not more than a minute. Nice pour, by the way. Clarebar.com, barproducts.com. By the way, all these really colorful trends, if you need anything, anything that's from behind your bar, from behind your bar. Barproducts.com. Come on, 30 streams, 3 bottles! Tomahawk in, same pattern, back, quick thumb roll. Nice. 30 seconds. Nice save. Hey! 15 seconds, 4 bottles. 2 columns, I'm gonna count you down, guys. Quick flash at 10, 9, 8, 7. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 10! Josh Golders! Nicely done!
Yes, the process of creating something which you are satisfied with wouldn't allow you to let people blend it with something else. Just drink it as it is. If you don't like it, don't drink it. That's my attitude. It's a very spectacular and unique landscape with very small farm lots where farming still is very active. If you want to keep that, you need to have farms that can live and thrive, and then they cannot just produce a staple product, they have to produce a high quality product.
It's a Cape who is early warm in the spring, therefore we can grow potatoes early, and it's a sandy soil, and it's not good for wheat or something else, but the potatoes are good here.
Virgin new potato is traditionally the most celebrated product on the Swedish plate. Why should such an extremely expensive raw material be used for vodka production? The only reason is that it has a flavor, it has a taste, which is different.
Where you're from?
What? Cocoa Beach.
Cocoa Beach! You live in Cocoa Beach?
Yep.
How far are you away from the beach?
Like half a block.
Do me a favor, hold my mic for 1 second.
You got it.
I was ready for you. Hi, where do you work, man?
The Radisson Resort at the port.
All right, all right.
Portable bars.
How long you been for bartending?
For about 9 months, a year, something like that.
Are you feeling good?
No, my start date.
I was watching your I was watching your practice. I think we got some good stuff. So Jared, get back there and have a good time. Ow! I wasn't ready. Jared, he's bartender number 14 on your sheet. Rookie bartender number 7. Let's do this. 3 minutes on the clock. We're just going to make 2 drinks. So Carlson Iceberg. You ready, man? Bring it up. And then the finest call, watermelon basil lemonade. Here we go, everybody. Oh, I love Cocoa Beach. On 3, 2, 1, go! Finest call right out of the gate. Come on. That's the brand new finest call, watermelon. Nice. Price is nice. Picture time. There's a Carlson Gold, sweetest virgin potato vodka. One bottle, 110. Okay, one bottle, now one bottle, 110. Oh, nicely done. That's a noon in. It bounced once. It is way too quiet out there. Come on, hospitality. I need you to make some noise. Bartenders, where are you? The correct answer is you are in paradise. Helena Isle. Smilebar.com. Carlson, finest call. Slayer got a new game. Jared is your bartender. Apparently he won't give up. 2 bottles. I stalled. There you go. Dude, I can almost see the music. Cool, thanks. Really? We're done. We're done. We're done. We're done. We're done. See? See? You should have gone to the pro. We could have given... No, we could have given you 4 minutes. Come here. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise, please, for Jared. He just competed for you. 3 minutes. He did pretty good. Are you proud of him? Are you proud of him? Did you just grab her boobs? Do it again.
Do it again.
Thank you. There it goes. Our new rating. No, sir. One more time for Jared, please. Jared did a good job. Let him know it. Thank you, man.
finest call, cinnamon apple sidecar. It is, in this heat, it's very refreshing. Finest call always makes a great product. So this is just delicious. As far as finest call products go, I think my best one and favorite one has to be the red sangria. It's so easy. You pop it open, add a little wine, some extra fruit, and it's a perfect sangria mix. All their mixes are like spot on flavor, but I like that one the best.
I agree, but finest call makes it so much easier as opposed to muddling the lime. I have the mix right there ready to go, along with some of their other flavors. As for strawberry daiquiris, lime juice, grenadine, all of their stuff is great. Their products last a really long time, and they're priced awesome.
Finest call, the premium mix for the best cocktail.
Finest Golf, premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
And premium mixers for premium cocktails.
That's what I'm talking about.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails! Woo!
Finest Golf, premium mixers for premium cocktails.
And don't forget, guys, if you ever want to remember, Finest Golf. It's a premium mix for premium cocktails. And we out.
The next one is up right now, professional bartender, Chris Rambler. Come here, Chris.
Oh, shit.
Everybody say hi, Chris. Hey, we got some fans here, man. Oh, baby, come here. Hold on, we got to interrupt you. Wait, I don't get one? There you go. I feed my judges first because they're the important ones.
How's it going over there?
Hey, Mercy's on.
That's awesome.
There we go. Fireball!
Rich! Richard!
Sorry, Rob, we had to do that for the judges.
Rich!
I guess I'll do mine later. Chris, come out and I've got to finish with you. Tell her you got your fan club here. Tell everybody where you work, sir.
I don't even bartend anymore, but I work at the Cheesecake Factory in Dayton.
Finally, I've been doing this for so many years. I'm like, God damn, if we could just get somebody from the Cheesecake Factory to represent.
All right, guys, you know what to do. One, two, three, Cheesecake Rock!
I don't think they were ready for you. Ready? Try it again. Swallow whatever's in your mouth. One, two, three,
Cheesecake
Rock! There we go. Are we ready? Judges, are we ready? Island Miranda, are you ready? Chris is here. Now, in 4 minutes on the clock, you're going to make the same two drinks we've been doing all night. I get my stopwatch to work. The Carlson Iceberg. And then the fine... he's ready for you. He's our pro. We don't worry about him. And then the fine is called Watermelon Basil Lemonade. On 3, 2, 1, go! You guys ready? I'll cue you one more time. You ready? Cheesecake Rocks. 1, 2, 3. Cheesecake Rocks. Well, Chris has been coming out for several years. We're used to seeing him behind the bar, but it's fun to see him again. The only thing wrong with those two tins is now they're gator colors. I'm okay with Miami. I'm from Tallahassee, that's all I'm saying. Too bad we're dead. I love you. Florida team. Chris! Make some drinks! If you're a bartender that's sitting around and is not familiar with that bottle that's on the floor, that is a new Swedish virgin potato vodka. Come around if you have it. It's awesome. Oh! Chris! I'm probably the only one on the planet that goes to Cheesecake Factory for the flare bar. Swing it! Finest call us in there! Old school!
Give me that dunk button on big old legs.
Hey!
And I'm shaving this gang. I'm gonna break it down in bag like Jane. Please!
Roll. It's in there. Cheesecake makes a move for your boy. My spleen. I stole that. I did. I really did. I did. Chris! Come here. Representing, of all places, the Cheesecake Factory, Chris! I dig the old school moves. I've got a little ladder action, some quick thumb rolls.
Most vodkas are distilled many, many times. They try to produce something which has no smell or taste at all. The whole idea of this project was to create something which had a taste of potatoes. That was the idea.
Kolsom vodka is made from 7 different variety of potatoes. We only distill once and what they call an unfiltered approach. And the reason for that is that we made such a big effort on growing and picking the potatoes that really makes a difference. Someone has taken great care from the very beginning. This is not an anonymous sort of raw material that has just been packaged into some kind of fancy label. And this is something unique from a unique region with a unique care and a lot of people and basically a whole community that stands behind it.
Bartender in this competition, I would not want to fly with. Probably takes you forever to get through fucking security, dude. Oh my god. Are you kidding? But seriously, props on the that's some effort right there. All right, Ramil, tell everybody something about yourself.
I am going to school and I'm working.
Cool. Where do you work?
Costco.
He works at Costco. Hold on, seriously. That's one of the things I love about bartenders. They do anything they have to do what they love, and this is what they love. You guys are here because you love what you do. Welcome to Holiday Isle. Ramil, get back behind the bar. We're going to watch what you do. Right now, we have 4 minutes on the clock because you are a professional bartender. A shot at $500. Please make for us. Are we ready? Judges, are we ready? Holiday Isle, are you ready? Make for us, right here. The Carlson Iceberg. And in the front... I like this. And then the finest call, watermelon. Please eliminate. Here we go. On 3, 2, 1, go. What the hell are you playing? His name is Ramil. Strike Martin. Ramil. Let's blow it up.
Rock on the top row.
The find is called Carson Gold. Carlson Gold. Flarebar.com 2013. The Holiday Isle. Bartenders in Paradise Competition. Looking for to the end. The Carlson Expert. I know that because he poured some of it in the ice. By his call. It's in there. Man, the wind is really kicking up. Remaining, that's like halfway, dude. Nice. Nice is nice. Yeah.
My personal favorite Finest Golf product is the agave syrup. I'm a big fan of it. It's way healthier than simple syrup. It's just as sweet. Regarding fresh versus prepared, I think it's important, once again, to remember how you use it. You know, I mean, if you're using a pre-made agave syrup, you can use that in conjunction with fresh juices to create excellent products. There's also a lot of products where there's not a significant difference between fresh and the product you can purchase. Passion fruit puree, for example, the amount of work, time, and product that goes into making it fresh, at the end, you end up with what Finest Call produces. Though pre-made purees have gotten a bad rap in the industry, I think it's much more important to focus on how you utilize them, because I think these cocktails are a great example of how you can use these purees to make absolutely amazing cocktails.
Alright, Juice, are you ready? Here's what we gotta do. We have had a long-standing tradition. You got some friends down there, don't you? Okay, so you guys know Juice, right? Alright. So if he falls down, you guys got him safe for the rest of the night? You got his back? I got a wrestler that can catch you. She'll probably slam you down later, but...
Hey, he's not gonna fall down!
The penalty for entering a contest late here at Amarada, if you got to do a warm shot of our major sponsor. So we need you to do right now, if you would, at least it's good stuff. You need three shots from you. The Carson Gold Potato Vodka. Cheers! If you have a drink, put it up in the air. We're toasting today. Juice! Juice! Yeah, it's better if you mix it with something and not warm. All right, I better start this before you fall on your face. All right. 3 minutes on the clock. If I can find my clock. Okay. All right, here we go. You're going to make for me, please, the Carlson Iceberg. Get the watch to work. And then the Finest Call Watermelon Basil Lemonade. Are you guys ready? Our next to last bartender, you say go when I go. 3, 2, 1,
go!
His name is Juice. And with any luck, in the next 3 minutes, he will not spew. Juice! Not a good start. I'm gonna stand back here.
It's all good, baby.
That bike is kicking in quick, huh? You might want to shut those tops, I'm just saying.
Every Saturday, rap attack, Mr. Magic, Molly Mall. I let my tape rock till my tape pop. Smoking weed and bamboo, sipping on private stock. Way back when I had the red and black lumberjack with the hat to match. Remember rapping through the hard, you never thought that hip hop.
Here we go, his name is Juice.
Cause I rock tight, time to get paid, blow up like the World Trade.
Alright, now we got his groove. That's the Juice that I know and love.
for dinner. Beat the raw team, pussy beat, take the free. Fuck Mac, the flex, my club.
Are you wearing your granddaddy's slippers?
Like you thought I would. Call a clip, say number Stanford. It's all good.
Shit. Oh, okay, the arrows. I didn't see it.
And if you don't know, it's not the know.
Yes! Where's my juice fans? Come on, make some money! Juice! That's a Carlson Gold Swedish virgin potato vodka. Virgin.
Just taking a picture. From the bottom, now we're here.
Apparently it's good for carpets too.
Starting from the bottom, now the whole team here. Starting from the bottom, now we're here. Starting from the bottom, now my whole team here.
Sorry, the wind must have blown it.
Starting from the bottom, now the whole team. Yeah, I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we argue every month. I was trying to get it on my own.
Jeez!
Working all night, traffic on the way home. And my uncle calling me like, where you at?
Is that vodka kicking in yet? 1 minute!
Bring it right back. I just think it's funny how it goes.
You might make it all the way.
Now I'm on the road, half a million bucks.
I don't know about that.
Starting from the bottom, now we're here. Starting from the bottom, now my whole team. Yeah, starting from the bottom, now we're here. Starting from the bottom, now the whole team.
Here we go.
Yeah, starting from the bottom, now we're here. Starting from the bottom, now the whole team. Yeah, starting from the bottom, now we're here.
Woo!
Starting from the bottom, now the whole team.
30 seconds.
Let's tell a story about the men.
Oh, that would have been great. 3 shots ago. There's a little bit of basil in that drink. It's like a fourth. 15, we gotta count you down. Oh, whatever, just put it anywhere. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, say juice! I know. Come here. This, what? Are you ready to take care of him? Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big hand for Juice? He survived. I don't know how.
Okay, I am now representing the Clevelanders, South Beach, and I'm still representing Friday, baby, all day, 12 years. Love y'all.
Juice!
It is in this heat, it's very refreshing. Finest Call always makes a great product, so this is just delicious. As far as Finest Call products go, I think my best one and favorite one has to be the red sangria. It's so easy, you pop it open, add a little wine, some extra fruit, and it's a perfect sangria mix. All their mixes are like spot on flavor, but I like that one the best.
I agree, but Finest Call makes it so much easier as opposed to muddling the lime. I have the mix right there ready to go, along with some of their other flavors. As for strawberry daiquiris, lime juice grenadine, all of their stuff is great. Their products last a really long time, and they're priced awesome.
Finest Call, the premium mix for the French cocktails.
Finest Call, premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixers for premium cocktails.
Premium mixes for premium cocktails.
That's what I'm talking about.
Premium mixes for premium cocktails. Woo!
Mine is called premium mixers for premium cocktails.
And don't forget, guys, if you ever want to remember, Finest Call. It's a premium mix for premium cocktails. And we out.
Alright, this could be interesting because apparently he's never done this before. So judges, judges, for your safety, be ready to run at any moment. He's never done this before, so when I say this is the splash zone, shots!
He needs to break the cherry once.
Get set. Whatever you're going to do, get set. All right, Prince, come here. Our final bartender tonight was entered without him actually knowing that it was entered, but he's gonna step up to the plate and do something for 3 minutes. But because you're a late entry, I need you to first do these 3 shots. The good news is it's amazing vodka. The bad news is it's warm and it's still good vodka. But I ordered one big shot, that works too.
I don't know if you remember.
Enjoy your Carlson Gold. Salute, everybody! Salute!
It's your birthday. It's your birthday.
Yum.
It's your birthday.
And the judges are ready for you, so they've. You're gonna make for me the last time tonight. I'm gonna say, Carlson Iceberg, Finest Call, Watermelon, Basil Lemonade.
He's in the
hole. You're already in the hole. You're already in the hole. 3, 2, 1, go!
They ask me what I do and who I do it for, and how I come up with this up in the studio. All I want for my birthday is a big booty call. All I want for my birthday is a big booty call. When I die, bury me inside the country style. When I die, bury me inside the lone style. All I want for my birthday is a big booty call. All I want for my birthday is a big booty call. She got a big booty, so I call her big booty. Wrist moving, cooking, getting to her. I'm in the kitchen, hams everywhere. Just made a jewel, I got fans everywhere. You the realest, breathing if I hold my breath. Referee,
halfway,
hold it tight. Extend up, extend up, extend up. Where your girl leave me, she need a house alone. Have we killed it going on the temple thumb?
Ah, seriously. 2 minutes remaining. Right, it's gonna start one time.
See, I'm going to do
it. Yeah, what's better if you're hoping it?
When I die, bury me inside the jury style.
Right, it's gonna start attempt number two.
So when I die, bury me next to two. They ask me what I do.
Now you're halfway. By the way, that seriously, that is a new. Mine is called Watermelon. Good stuff, fun stuff. He nailed it! Nailed it! One minute remaining. Come on, Prince. Representing the Heat out of Miami. This is LeBron James' personal crumpler. What? When he sees this tape, he's gonna kick my ass. Oh, oh, I like that move. 30 seconds! That's all right. Okay, I gotta count you down, everybody. For the last time tonight, do it for Frederick Stone. Click at 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, nobody's dead! Ho! Because he stepped up and made a man out of it, did I ever think of Federico? That's Prince! Alright, judges are going to tabulate their scores. We're going to play some more music for him. We'll be back with a $500 and a trophy to the biggest winner.
Where is the
bring it up for 1 second. Bring it up for 1 second. Hey, judges?
work.
Where do you work?
I want you to come space. Yeah. You want to come by and say you know Fritz? I got you.
Just got off work?
Ready, work. I just got off work a couple hours ago, yeah. I don't have a watch on, but I'm pretending. A couple hours ago.
Oh, I see that.
Go Heat!
Let's go Heat, baby!
Judges, you'll appreciate this.